10 Dean Koontz books that I've read, and I've read most of them, apart from a lot of his early stuff, because that's hard to find because it's all out of print. But then again, most of that stuff wasn't any good, so it probably wouldn't have been on this list anyways. Let's begin. Coming in at number 10 is actually an earlier book from his career, Night Chills. It makes you hate advertising, but it's really honestly one of his like breakthrough kind of seminal moments where he took elements of sci-fi, stuck them in more contemporary settings, mixed them with elements, strong elements, basically he mixed them into thriller novels, and that's what Koontz is. With this thing, it's a very plausible, terrifying tale. And because this was early in his career, there was actually kind of a surprise for me halfway through, where a lot of some things that Koontz will just straight up refuse to do later in his career, he would do at this point. So it kind of took me by surprise in a very good way. But yeah, just awesome, awesome book that'll make you think about things that advertisers are doing. Next up, we have one of his, probably his most famous book, Odd Thomas. I don't know, maybe Watchers is more famous, or Frankenstein. But Odd Thomas, it's a lot like the Chris Snow character. If you've read those books, the character is very, very similar personality-wise. But Odd Thomas is a fun, goofy, fun-loving guy. You shouldn't say fun in the same sentence, Travis. But he sees dead people. So it's the sixth sense, but he does something about it, damn it. Which I think was like the tagline of the movie. Very heartbreaking ending to the first book. The series as a whole kind of gets preachy towards the end. I didn't really care for the last three or four books. But the first book and the first couple books are really good. The first book is fantastic. The ending will make you shed a tear. Unless you ain't got a soul. Because you might be Frankenstein. And Frankenstein ain't got no soul. Because it came down on the lightning. I just did a whole review on this, so you can go check that out for more in-depth detail. But I love the way that Frankenstein originally, Mary Shelley's Frankenstein, was basically like prototype Koontz, where it's sci-fi mixed with horror. And so when Koontz got a hold of it, he did an awesome, awesome job. Great characters, great story, pacing. Everything is fantastic, apart from, I think Koontz's worldview got in the way a bit, but still, the first trilogy in the Frankenstein series is awesome. And coming up next, we've got the best novel he has written, according to Stephen King. It says so right there on the back. It's called Strangers. It's a big book, and Koontz really doesn't write very many big books. So, you know, when King writes a big book, I'm a little bit leery of it because it might be very bloated. It might not be. Like, The Stand is a humongous book, but it's not bloated. But we're talking about Koontz. Move back to Koontz. Koontz doesn't write many thick, you know, like, door chalk books. And this is one of them. And this is the very first book that he wrote entirely without an outline. He had been writing outlines for the entirety of his career up until this point, but he had been getting off of them for the last several years. So this time he's just like, you know what? I'm just not gonna bother. And he wrote a goodie. It's moves well, has tons and tons of characters. They're all unique, interesting. Great, great book. This is really hearkening into when Koontz was really, really getting into his golden age and really getting into a groove of things. Next up on the list, we've got Lightning. So Lightning is a time travel, but a new type of time travel. And I'm not gonna spoil it if you haven't read it, but it's an entirely new take. Well, as far as I know, it's an entirely new take. It might not actually be, but a nice, unique take. There's not a ton of books that I know of. I don't know of another one, so there can't be a ton of them that take this type of premise. And it goes through the entirety of a girl's life. Like you meet her as a little girl, and you get to know her and go through her tragedy, her trials and tribulations, and move into adulthood. And there's some really sad moments in here where some bad stuff happens. And it makes you feel the feels. Great book, like a top 10 Koontz book. Really is. When I think prototypical Koontz, this is actually like one of them that I think of. Next up, let's kick it up a notch with Intensity. This is a very intense book. Very intense, Intensity. It's not real big and it's just intense. This has, to me, Koontz's best villain in it. The one that is just the best portrayed, and he has some really good villains. Koontz does a great job with psychopaths. This one, Edgler Vess, the serial killer in here, is just fantastic. And I love pretty much everything about this book. This book is almost perfect. There's some weird stuff that happens with moose. I think there were moose, they might have been elk. There were some stuff going on with animals that I thought was a little out of place, and otherwise really, really, really great book. It's very intense. You should check it out. Next up, we've got Balding Koontz, Before He Recognized That He Could Get Hair Implants. It's Dragon Tears. That's what it is. It's Dragon Tears. So, I don't know how much I want to give away about this book. There's a guy in here that's extreme narcissist and has a lot of power, and he expresses it in a very unique way. And so, this had his main characters, Koontz's main characters, were just, they was in trouble. I mean, he wrote them into a wall like no other. And they got out of it, and they did it without going all Deus, which happens a lot of the time. So Koontz actually managed to write them into a corner, and then he wrote them out of the corner and did it well. Fantastic book. I love it. One of his best. You know what else is one of his best books? False Memory. I believe I made a review on this one as well, so you can go check this one out. This one is really quite similar to Night Chills. It's written later in his career, very much in Golden Age Koontz. So it's like a redone, better version of Night Chills, but it's really, really good. The characters are all very well thought out. The first part of the book, you're really wondering what the hell's going on. The second part of the book, you're wondering how the hell they're gonna survive. Koontz did a masterful job. Masterful job. Great book. I would put it on a top 10 list. I don't know why I say that books are great when they're on a top 10 list. Of course they're great, they're on the top 10 list. Gosh, Chavez is running out of superlatives. Look, it's Balding Koontz again! Balding Koontz Part 2. Will I grow it back? The search for Rogaine. Okay, yeah, this one is also called Mr. Murder. This is actually the very first Koontz book that I ever read. And I came back for more Koontz. So that should tell you that it's good. Also, it's on this list. So it's good. But you know how you're always like, hey, I wish I had a twin brother or twin sister. This book really takes it like, do you really want one of those? Do you? Great book. Golden Age Koontz. Most of these books are in Golden Age Koontz. So, that you would think, like, so much obvious stuff going on with this list. It's like, try to just list the books and get out of your damn way. Twilight Eyes, number one! So this was earlier Golden Age Koontz. I believe it's early 87. This was originally written in 85, the first half of the book. And then he wrote the second half of the book and republished it in 87. I think this one was originally called Twilight. So yes, Dean Koontz did write Twilight. This was the original Dean Koontz Twilight. There's actually a bunch of Twilight. Stephen King actually wrote Twilight as well. And then there was a Twilight movie that came out in like 1998. So, you know, Stephanie Meyer is definitely not a hipster because she was late to the Twilight party. One of the original Twilights. The first part of this book, you kind of wonder if the main character's entirely sane. The second part of the book, you're wondering how he's gonna stay alive. Just really unique premise and setup and delivery. Everything's unique about it, and this is like the prototype of why I do like Koontz. What you can see his roots as a sci-fi writer and taking those elements that make good sci-fi and combining them with thriller, the elements that make good thriller, and then you have a good thriller sci-fi. And this one, I think it's his best book. What do you know? It's the number one on the top 10 Koontz books that I've read. And I've read most of them. If you haven't read Koontz and you want to start with Koontz, this is a good one. It's also a little bit on the thick side for Koontz, which kind of makes sense because originally just the first half came out. And I think the second half came out in like a magazine or special printing or something. I don't remember. But it very quickly got put back together. And in the middle of this book, it'll say like, that's the end of part one. This book will be continued on the very next page. And originally it said this book will be continued wherever else that it would have been continued. But Koontz's research really shows in this one as well with carny life. And that was, for me, the carnivals were dead by the time I came along. I didn't get to see carny life like I did in this book. Carny life is really unique, and Koontz did a fantastic job of portraying it, wrapped up in a fantastic thriller sci-fi novel. The end of the world. It's good. But those are my top 10 Dean Koontz books that I've read. So let me know, did you like the books that I've listed? What's your top 10? We all want to know your top 10s. Start your top 10 right now. Right now, get on it. So if you like my list, hit the like button. Let me know that you love me. I like feeling the loves. I like feeling Girl Scout cookies in my mouth as well, so you can feel free to send me boxes of Thin Mints. Preferably by the caseload, that'd be great. It'd also be great if you hit subscribe so that, you know, we can party like this more often. We like to party around. But until next time, stay awesome.